Maybe I'd like to introduce first how I come about to choose this word. The word is follow. Letter F, spelling is F-A-L-L-O-W, follow. I didn't know the origin of this word also. I also searched for the meaning of this word today because I thought maybe if I should teach a new word, I should learn it first, learn a new one. This is not to be confused with the word follow, which is F-O-L-L-O-W, which is quite common. But this one is F-A-L-L-O-W. It is an adjective, usually for farmlands, which means plowed and unharrowed, but left unsown for a period in order to restore its fertility as part of a crop rotation or to avoid surplus production. Incentive for farmers to let the land lie fallow in order to reduce grain surpluses. However, I chose this word not because of its agricultural meaning. I chose it because it also has a figurative meaning. It's a figurative meaning which means inactive. Long fallow periods when nothing seems to happen. When something seems not to be happening, it's a fallow period. It's like the land you leave untouched to let it become fertile again. A fallow trading period, inactive, dormant, quiet, slack, slow, stagnant, barren, unproductive. The antonym of which is busy. So the opposite of busy is fallow. Now if I were to use it in my own sentence, there were probably several months in my Toastmasters life where I was not giving speeches, not attending, and it is one of my fallow Toastmasters period, which I don't like to happen again. So tonight I'll be trying to do two things also. First is to scout for the good use of language. Rather than just be taking note of the bad use of language, I'd like us to scout for the good use of language. And then, as Ms. Farkanda, Toastmaster Farkanda has reminded me, I will also do the counting of the ask for tonight. So, let's have a pleasant meeting tonight.